CIET NCERT presents Audiobook of EVS for Class 5, entitled Looking Around 5. This is Lesson 6, Every Drop Counts, from page 51 to page 59. Let's listen to Lesson 6. Page 51. 6. Every Drop Counts. Long, long ago. This page has a picture of Ghat Sisar. Sar means a lake. King Ghatsi of Jaisalmer got it made 650 years ago with the help of the people. All around the lake there are ghats with steps leading to the water, decorated verandas, large halls, rooms and much more. People came here to celebrate festivals and for programs of music and dance. Children came to study in the school on the ghat. The talab belonged to everyone and everyone took care to keep it clean. Rainwater collected in this lake spread over many miles. It was made in such a way that when the lake was full, the extra water flowed into another lake at a lower level. When that too filled up, the extra water flowed into the next lake. This way, all 9 lakes filled up. This rainwater could be used throughout the year. Today, Ghat Sisar is no more in use. Many new buildings and colonies have come up in between those 9 lakes. Now the water does not get collected in these lakes. Rainwater just flows away and is wasted. Page 52. This page has a fact box with a postage stamp of Al-Biruni. The heading says, Through the Eyes of Al-Biruni. More than 1,000 years ago, a traveller came to India. His name was Al-Biruni. The place that he came from is now called Uzbekistan. Al-Biruni carefully observed and noted down the details of all that he saw. He wrote especially about those things that he found very different from his own country. Here is a part of what he wrote about the ponds of that time. The people here are very skilled at making ponds. My countrymen would be surprised to see them. They pile up huge rocks and join them with iron rods to build chabutras, that is, raised platforms, all around the lake. Between these, there are rows of long staircases going up and down. The steps for going up and coming down are separate, so there is less crowding. Today, when we study history, we can learn a lot about those days from the writings of Al-Biruni. This stamp came out in 1973, 1,000 years after his birth. Observe and find out. Look at the area around your school. Are there any fields, farms, pakka roads, drains, etc.? Is the area sloping, rocky or flat? Think what will happen here when it rains. Where will the rainwater go? Into the drains, pipes or pits? Is some water also getting soaked into the soil? Drop by drop. Besides Jaisalmer, many places in Rajasthan get very little rainfall. Here it rains for only a few days in the entire year, sometimes not even that much. The rivers here do not have water all round the year. Teacher's note, we can tell children how Al-Biruni's book is helpful to know about the past. Also discuss about other sources of history, such as old buildings, coins, paintings, etc. Help children to locate Uzbekistan in the world map. Page 53. And yet, most of the villages in these areas did not have a shortage of water. People knew that every drop of water was precious. Lakes and joharts were made to collect water. Water was everyone's need. One and all came together in this work, be it a businessman or a labourer. Some water from the lakes soaked into the ground and reached the wells and bavadis, that is, step well. The soil of the area also became wet and fertile. Every house had a system to collect the rainwater. The picture is showing how the rainwater falling on the roof reaches the underground tank through a pipe, which is being collected by a lady with the help of a rope and a bucket from an opening on the roof. The second picture on this page is of a step well. In a step well, the steps go down several stories deep. Instead of drawing the water up from the well, the people could go down the steps and reach the water. That is why they are called step wells. Teacher's note: how does the earth soak water and how does it reach wells and step wells? This can be discussed with children. Page 54. Long ago, people used to make long journeys with their caravans of animals and goods. People felt it was a good thing to give water to thirsty travelers. Thus, they built many beautiful step wells. Have you ever faced a shortage of water in your area? If yes, then what was the reason for it? Talk to your grandmother or any elderly person. Find out when they were of your age. A. From where did they get water for the house? Has there been a change now? B. What kind of water arrangements were made for travelers? For example, piau, mashak, that's a leather bag, or any other. Now what do people do about water when they travel? Customs related to water. Even today, people get water from very old lakes, dharas, step wells, and nalas. Many customs and festivals are related to water. At some places, whenever lakes get filled up with rainwater, the people gather around the lake to celebrate. There is a picture on the left side of this page, where a bride from Uttarakhand is performing some rituals alongside a stream of water. After getting married, she has come to the new village. She bows to the spring or the pond. In cities, one can see an interesting form of this custom. The new bride worships the tap in her home. Can we even imagine life without water? Page 55. Do you have some special pots for water at your place? There are two pictures on this page. In the first picture, water is being filled in a beautiful copper pot. And the second picture consists of a shining yellow pot of brass. Many stone carvings are also made near the place of drinking water. Have you ever seen any beautiful building near the place of water? Where? Find out. Is there a lake, well, or step well near your house or school? Visit it and find out more about it. A. How old is it? Who got it built? B. What kinds of buildings are around it? C. Is the water clean? Is it cleaned regularly? D. Who all use the water? E. Is there any festival celebrated at this place? F. Is there any water today? Or is it dry? Page 56. Think over it. In 1986, there was no rain in Jodhpur and the surrounding areas. People remembered the old and forgotten step well, that's Bauli. They cleaned the step well and more than 200 trucks of garbage was taken out of it. People of the area collected money. The thirsty town got water from the step well. After a few years, it rained well. And again, the step well was forgotten. Discuss. There are two old wells in the area where Punita lives. Her grandmother says that about 15-20 years ago, there was water in these wells. The wells could have dried up because A. Water is being pumped up from under the ground with the help of electric motors. B. The lakes in which rainwater used to collect are no longer there. C. The soil around trees and parks is now covered with cement. D. Is there some other reason for this? Explain. The story today. Let's find out different ways in which people manage water today on page 57 and then discuss. Do you get water in your house by any of these ways? Put a tick on that. If you get water by some other way, write in your notebook. Teacher's note. Discuss the unequal distribution of water with children. It is important to know how people get water from different sources and the problems they face. Though it is challenging, yet it is important to discuss issues of caste and class related to water, especially from the children's perspective. Page 57. This page has 8 colorful pictures with the caption, "This is how we get water," written in the center. First picture has a boy with a water tanker in the background where people have queued up to fetch water. The boy is saying,
"A jalboat water tanker comes to our colony twice a day. We have to stand in a long queue to get water from the tanker. People at times have fights over water."
In the second picture, a village girl with a water well in her background is saying,
"We fill water from the well. The nearby well dried up a year ago. Now we have to walk far to reach the other well. We are not allowed to take water from some of the wells because of our caste."
The third picture has a small girl with a roof tank in the background. She is saying,
"We get water at home for half an hour. We fill this in the tank to use all day. Sometimes it's dirty."
In the fourth picture, a girl is standing in her bathroom where water is running out of the tap on the basin. She is saying,
"We get water from our taps all day long."
In the fifth picture, a hand pump is shown and a boy is saying,
"There is a hand pump nearby, but the water that we get from it is salty. We have to buy water for drinking."
In the sixth picture, a water pump is shown and a boy is saying,
"We have put a pump directly in the jalboat pipeline. Now we don't have any problem."
A motor pump is shown on the crop fields in the seventh picture and a boy is explaining,
"We have put a motor to pump up the water from the bore well, but there is no electricity. So what do we do?"
And in the eighth picture, 2 women are filling water in their earthen pots from a canal. One woman is saying,
"We get water from the canal itself."
Page 58. Discuss. Everyone has the right to live. Yet, is everybody getting enough water to live or even water to drink? Why is it that some people have to buy drinking water? Should it be like this? Water on this earth is for one and all. Some people draw out water from the ground by deep bore wells. How far is it correct? Have you ever seen this? Why do some people put a pump directly in the jalboat pipeline? What problems would other people face due to this? Do you have any such experience? There is a picture of a jalboat bill here. Study it and tell. A. From which office has the bill come? Do you get a water bill at home? Find out from where it is sent. C. Why do you think Delhi Sarkar, that's Government of Delhi, is written under Delhi Jal Board? D. In whose name is the bill? How much money do they have to pay for each month? E. Do you have to pay for water? How much? Is the rate of water different in different colonies? Ask your elders. Page 59. It can be done. There are some groups that work hard to bring water to the people of different areas. They ask the elders about the water arrangement in their times. They rebuild the old lakes and johars and also build new ones. Let us see how the group called Tarun Bharat Sangh helped Darkimai. There's a story box on this page with a picture of an old lady. This is Darkimai. She lives in a village in the Alwar district of Rajasthan. The women of the village used to spend the entire day looking after their home and animals. Sometimes it took them all night to pull water from the well for the animals. In the summer, when the wells dried up, they had to leave the village. Darkimai heard about this group and asked for help. Together, the people from the group and the village decided to make a lake. The problem of food and water for animals is now less. People get more milk. They have started earning more. From the book, Char Gaon Ki Katha.
Have you ever read this kind of news in any newspaper? How did people solve their problem of water? Did they repair and reuse any old lake or step well? What we have learnt. Make a poster. Do you remember the slogan, "Water on Earth is for one and all"? Think of some other such slogans. Draw pictures and make a nice poster. Bring a water bill. Look at it and tell. How much money is to be paid for this bill? See. What else can you see in the bill? Like the money spent on repair, maintenance, etc. Chapter 6 of total 22 chapters of the book, Looking Around 5, ends here. Narrator, Richa Sayal. Producer, Vimlesh Chaudhary. Presented by CIET NCERT, New Delhi, India.